Hi there. In this video, I'm going to go over the results of some benchmark tests I ran on my iPhone 11 and my iPhone 16 Plus to see if after nearly 5 years between their releases, how much the performance has improved. If you get value from this video, please hit the like button and consider subscribing. Before I get into the test results, I just wanted to quickly go over the core specs of the two phones that I have, along with some criteria that could impact the tests. First, the iPhone 11 has the A13 Bionic chip with 6 cores, 2 of which being performance and 4 being efficiency, and a 4-core GPU. The total RAM is 4GB, and for the storage it is 128GB. The display is 6.1 inches with a resolution of 828 by 1792 pixels. The iPhone 16 Plus has the A18 chip with 6 cores, 2 again of performance and 4 efficiency, and a 5-core GPU this time. The total RAM is 8GB, and for storage it has 256GB. The display is 6.7 inches with a resolution of 1290 by 2796 pixels. Both iPhones were running the same version of iOS, which is iOS 18.5 at the time of this recording. No background apps were open and the power saving mode was off. Both iPhones were on battery power as well. Lastly, Apple Intelligence was disabled on the iPhone 16 Plus. Now, let's get to the test results, starting with AnTuTu. The first test I ran was the AnTuTu storage test. For reference, the version used was 10.1.0. The iPhone 16 Plus finished in 10 seconds with a score of 77,570, and the iPhone 11 finished in 22 seconds with a score of 37,051. Breaking down the individual elements of the test, you can see the scores are more than double for the iPhone 16 Plus versus the iPhone 11, with the exception being random access read and write tests, where the difference is around roughly 1.62 times faster on the iPhone 16 Plus. To conclude the storage test, this results in a total of roughly 1.93 times improvement on the iPhone 16 Plus over the 11. However though, the capacity on the 16 Plus is twice the size of the iPhone 11, so that will likely also have an impact on the score and potentially other upgrades made on the 16 Plus. Moving on to the AnTuTu benchmark tests, the iPhone 16 Plus finished in 11 minutes and 28 seconds with a score of 1,711,338. The iPhone 11 finished in 12 minutes and 13 seconds with a score of 799,206. From the scores, we can see that the iPhone 16 Plus scored roughly 2.14 times higher than the iPhone 11, but that's only part of the story. The biggest gains are in both the CPU and GPU tests, which resulted in 2.85 and 2.86 times increases respectively for the iPhone 16 Plus. The memory and user experience tests resulted in much less score increases for the iPhone 16 Plus, with 1.37 and 1.43 times increases respectively. Now, this doesn't mean that the iPhone 16 Plus is less performant, it just shows that the improvements are not in every aspect double or more. If you do have apps that require more CPU and or GPU speed, such as games for example, they will likely run better on the iPhone 16 Plus versus the 11, but that would have been the case no matter what. Now, let's move on to Geekbench. First, I'll start with the CPU tests. For reference, the version of Geekbench used was 6.4 for both the CPU and GPU tests. The total time it took for the iPhone 16 Plus was 4 minutes and 17 seconds, and 5 minutes and 51 seconds for the iPhone 11. As for the scores, the CPU single core scores are 1760 for the iPhone 11 and 3458 for the iPhone 16 Plus. That's just under twice the score, roughly 1.96 times, for the iPhone 16 Plus over the iPhone 11. The CPU multicore scores are 3707 for the iPhone 11 and 8555 for the iPhone 16 Plus. That's just over 2.3 times the score for the iPhone 16 Plus over the iPhone 11. Moving on to the GPU tests, the total time it took for the iPhone 16 Plus was 1 minute and 18 seconds, and for the iPhone 11, it was 1 minute and 53 seconds. The iPhone 11 scored 13,899, and the iPhone 16 Plus scored 28,059, which again is just over twice the score, 2.0 times, for the iPhone 16 Plus versus the iPhone 11. Overall, the iPhone 16 Plus scores twice as much in Geekbench 6, with the single core CPU test being just a whisker under twice as much. So what conclusions can we take from these test results? The iPhone 16 Plus scores significantly higher across the majority of the tests, but didn't result in them completing in half the time, or better, except for the AnTuTu storage test, but that could have been influenced by the capacity being doubled. I can't say for certain, as I don't know if Apple uses multiple NAND chips for the 256GB model, which I doubt for this kind of capacity, or if they're using a faster version of PCIe for their NVMe interface. Either way, the iPhone 16 Plus is much more performant overall than the 11 in both the AnTuTu and Geekbench tests. Now, these are synthetic benchmark tests, so your mileage may vary. If you need to know about how a particular app performs on an iPhone 16 Plus, have a search on YouTube to see if anyone's running it to get an idea of how it runs. So, is it worth getting the iPhone 16 Plus as an upgrade from the 11? Based on the benchmark results, I would say yes, but at the same time, given that the iPhone 17 range is potentially only a few months away at the time of recording this video, maybe it would be worth waiting for that instead, especially if Apple decides to reduce the price of the 16 and 16 Plus when the 17s are released. Also, the iPhone 11 will get iOS 26, so maybe you could sweat your iPhone 11 if you have one for another year, if it does what you need it to do, and don't have much of a need or a reason to upgrade. The choice is ultimately yours. For now, I'll leave it at that. If you get value from this video, please hit the like button and consider subscribing. If you want some iPhone tips and tricks, I have a playlist with some here on the left. And if you want to watch another video that I thought you might like, or YouTube did, it's here on the right. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.